Hi, thanks for joining me again. So today is going to be a very fun video slash tutorial on how I achieve my look using the new Alice through the Looking Glass palette from Urban Decay. So they collaborated with Disney for the new movie that's going to be released called Alice Through the Looking Glass, and I think it would have been really fun, so I could not pass up the opportunity to just think outside the box and just swatch these beautiful colors and just come up with something really fun. So I hope you enjoy this, and I'm just going to jump right into it. Okay, so as you can tell, my eyebrows are already done, and I've actually used my e.l.f. dual-ended sticks, and it was supposed to be a highlight contour sticks, and I was surprised it actually came out pretty good. So I used it in medium dark. And I have a video on how to use the e.l.f. contour sticks the way it was intended. But yes, I've already done that using this stick, highlighted it a little. And then I found this from MAC laying in my counter, my makeup counter. It's Girl Boy from MAC, and I highlighted my eyebrows even further. So I've done half already, and I'm just gonna do the other half. So this is my power of makeup. Fun. So if you see me looking away, I'm just gonna get right into it and kind of let you know what I'm putting on, okay? So this is what the palette looks like. So beautiful. So the first thing I'm gonna do is prime my eyelids using, of course, Urban Decay Primer Potion. So let me just start all the way down in the corners. So then I'm gonna go into Hatter. Pardon me. Heads will roll. Sorry. That's what I use first. Heads would roll. I want to say the inner third of my lid. Heads would roll is so beautiful. And then for the rest of my lid, I went with Metamorphosis. I don't know if you can see that. Apply that there, pat it on. Okay, so then on my inner corner, I used Dream On. Dream On, dream away. Put it right in there. Dream On. Right in the corner. Right where I have my primer. Brings a little sparkle. Love that little sparkly, pretty color. And just a little bit on the middle of the lid as well. Just a little. Just add some sparkle. Okay, not too much. Okay, next is where it starts to get crazy. So I didn't even say I wanted to incorporate all of the characters and get a chance to use all of the colors as much as I can. Obviously I can't use all of the colors, but I can use a lot of them. So, and I'm gonna. So next, I'm gonna use this beautiful Salazen Grum. So it's so pretty. And create a halo. All the way out the other side, come down. The looking kind of even now. It's bright, huh? Love this. Right. Then, not this one. I used Paradox. Pretty orange, sparkly orange. And I placed it on the rest of my bottom lid. For my brow bone, let's not forget the brow bone. I used two colors, the palette. I used Reflection. And I placed it right here. And then in again. Reflection. I'm messing up my eye. And then I also use Looking Glass at the very top. There's some fallout. I said nothing too crazy. Then I blended. Rules, rules, rules. We're still following some rules here in Wonderland. So start blending all of this in. Next, I got this bold line. So for that bold line, what did I use? This nice little brush. This is my handy brush. So good for this. I'm using Revlon Colorstays Gel Cream Liner. If I go wrong with this, I will have to literally start from scratch. Ain't nobody got time for that. So, let me see. Gonna make like a nice straight line. It's kind of bad right now, but then what I did was I went over it with my e.l.f. It's a guideline. I'm thinking I'm satisfied with that line. I'm not the best line person. Next, I contoured my nose with Cake. Only in Wonderland. So I went in where Salz and Grum meets a little bit, and I put Cake, and I brought it all the way down. And I really act like I'm contouring. Like seriously. Seriously trying to blend it like this is a normal color, but in Wonderland, it is a normal color. This is really beautiful and fun. Then eyelashes. So I used was that Arda? Put a little bit on the bottom lash. And we contour and everything. Then I have my rainbow highlight that I made. And if you don't know how to make this, Graveyard Girl has a very dramatic rendition of how to make this. It's originally a big craze from Bitter Lace Beauty. They sold out, and there's one on eBay for actually over $1,200. So, yeah. So you choose, you decide. You pay $1,200, or you could go to Graveyard Girl on YouTube tutorial on how to make one of these. And it's actually not too bad. So, only here in Wonderland, you get to contour with cake and highlight. Push with rainbows. One swipe. So beautiful. Okay, now for the most interesting part. What I think is so interesting is my lips. I'm gonna use Jeffree Star Breakfast at Tiffany's. Whew. My ColourPop Creeper, kind of like fill in that heart. Then, where is my cheapie? From Aphorism, I have this cheap little gloss I got at TJ Maxx. Just gonna make my heart glossy. Really good. And then, as usual, the MAC Fix Plus. Hi, so I am back and ready for my close-up. I had a lot of fun today reviewing the new Alice Through the Looking Glass, I should say, Urban Decay collaboration with Disney on this beautiful palette. And for extra drama and animation, I went ahead and I used this glow in the dark wink eyelashes on the bottom lashes from Jerome Russell. So this is what we have, and I just want to thank you for watching. This was a lot of fun. I mean, with a palette like this and a name like that, who could pass up the opportunity to go crazy? We're all mad here. Okay, so thanks for watching.